sodium glucose co-transporter 2 inhibitors that was mentioned as a way of preventing heart failure in patients with diabetes may actually be a therapy for patients with heart failure even in the absence of diabetes. Some interesting speculation about mechanisms there, but large-scale trials are going on to evaluate a novel use of an already existing medication.
For right now, the biggest excitement has to be with the SGLT-2 inhibitors that are coming down. There have been two studies which have both been positive for cardiovascular outcomes as well as heart failure. I think the kind of interesting thing about that is that the benefits themselves are the mechanisms behind why they're beneficial are kind of hard to explain. And as we go back taking the clinical results and try and explain it with science, we're learning that perhaps these medicines are working in ways that aren't specific to diabetes. And that what's happening now is these medications, which started out as diabetic medications, are now being tested in people who have heart failure, who don't have diabetes. They're taking these medicines potentially from a diabetic medicine and really calling it a cardiovascular medicine. And I think that is interesting because there are new pathways and old pathways that we're revisiting that may provide further insight into cardiovascular disease and heart failure down the road.
Yeah, so I think probably the most exciting class is the SGLT2 inhibitor class, because if you look at the development with EMPA-REG and then CANVAS, you know, there were heart failure patients included in those, but the focus wasn't on heart failure regardless of diabetes. So now there are ongoing studies that are looking at patients that have heart failure and may not even have diabetes, and looking at some of these agents that were obviously initially developed for diabetes. And then, so you have large outcome studies, but also important mechanistic learnings from these studies that have been completed. So Jim Januzzi and others were involved with a nice paper out of CANVAS that looked at trying to understand why are we actually seeing this cardiovascular benefit. And what they nicely presented was that you see canagliflozin is actually having a favorable effect on the cardiac biomarkers.
The CANVAS program included CANVAS and CANVAS-R, which was the second half, if you will, of the two trials. And CANVAS, the CANVAS program demonstrated a very similar reduction in cardiovascular risk, 14% reduction, a hazard ratio of 0.86 for the triple major adverse cardiovascular event outcome of cardiovascular death, myocardial infarction, and stroke. That modest reduction in risk was accompanied by a rather robust 30 to 35% reduction in new onset heart failure events, really arguing very similarly as was seen in the EMPA-REG outcome study with empagliflozin, that these diabetes drugs really look like a heart failure therapy in disguise.